Introduction. The 3500 series engine is a diesel engine with a 4-stroke cycle. It has a 60-degree V angle between the cylinders of the block. The cylinder bore is 170 millimeters and the piston stroke is 190 millimeters. Each cylinder has approximately 4,310 cu. Standard engine rotation is counterclockwise. The 3516B engine is equipped with Meui fuel system. In this video tutorial, we'll explain about the Meui fuel system.
The operation of the Meui fuel system is quite different from that of mechanically controlled fuel systems. In order to troubleshoot an Meui system effectively, you must have a basic understanding of how it works. To help you learn the basics of the Meui system, we'll introduce each system component and then show how these components work together. The Meui fuel system consists of 5 major components. Electronic unit injectors produce fuel injection pressures up to 152 megapascals, or 22,000 psi, and fire up to 15 times per second at rated speed. The fuel transfer pump supplies the injectors by drawing fuel from the tank and pressurizing it to about 400 kilopascals, or 60 psi. The ECM is a powerful computer which controls all major engine functions. Sensors are electronic devices which monitor engine performance parameters such as pressure, temperature, or speed, and supply this information to the ECM by means of a signal voltage. Actuators are electronic devices which use electrical currents from the ECM to change engine performance. An example of an actuator is the injector solenoid. Now that we have introduced the major system components, let's discuss the operation of each component in more detail. We'll start with the mechanical components and then cover the electronic components. Diesel fuel systems use a plunger and barrel to pump high-pressure fuel into the combustion chamber. The cam lobes, push rods, and rocker arms mechanically actuate the injectors. The term MEUI is actually an abbreviation for Mechanically Actuated Electronically Controlled Unit Injector. Major parts of the injector include the tappet, plunger, body, nozzle assembly, and cartridge valve. The nozzle assembly consists of a nozzle spring, nozzle check, and nozzle tip. The cartridge valve consists of a valve body, solenoid, armature, poppet valve, and poppet spring. On 3500 engines, the injector is housed in a one-piece cast bore. No injector sleeve is used. This cast wall of the injector bore separates the injector from engine coolant. The injector nozzle case seats directly on the cylinder head to provide a more positive combustion gas seal. Actuation refers to the type of force used to power the plunger, which pumps the fuel out of the injector. Mechanically actuated fuel systems use a camshaft lobe and rocker arm to provide that force. The rocker arm presses down on the tappet at the top of the injector. The tappet, in turn, presses down on the injector plunger, which pushes fuel from the plunger cavity below the plunger. Fuel displaced from the plunger cavity can flow in 2 directions. Fuel can flow to the nozzle assembly and to the nozzle tip. However, to flow out of the tip, the injection pressure must reach about 38 megapascals, or 5,500 psi, in order to raise the nozzle check against the force of the nozzle spring. The fuel chooses the path of least resistance. It flows around the normally open poppet in the cartridge valve assembly to the fuel supply passage in the cylinder head. When injection is desired, the ECM sends a current to the solenoid on the cartridge valve. The current creates a magnetic field, causing the poppet to close. Fuel flow past the poppet is blocked, and pressure begins to build from the poppet through the plunger cavity to the nozzle check. When the pressure reaches approximately 38 megapascals, or 5,500 psi, the force of the high-pressure fuel overcomes the spring tension holding the nozzle check closed. The check lifts off its seat, and fuel flows out of the orifice holes in the nozzle tip. This is the start of injection. The rapid flow of fuel out of the plunger cavity is restricted by the very small orifice holes. Because of this restriction, injection pressure continues to rise very rapidly, even after the nozzle check opens and injection begins. Injection pressures continue to rise until the flow rate out of the orifice holes equals that of the fuel leaving the plunger cavity. Depending on engine speed and fuel delivery, this pressure ranges from about 69 megapascals, or 10,000 psi, to 152 megapascals, or 22,000 psi. High injection pressures promote complete combustion and lower exhaust emissions. Pushing the fuel through the orifice holes in the nozzle tip